Can you bring us up to speed where Charles Xavier is at this moment at the start of Logan? Don't worry about all the other films.
Okay, well, Charles Xavier is in both physically in a very different place from where he has been accustomed to being seen, which was the elegant mansion, which was Charles Xavier's school for gifted children. In fact, the transformation only became fully clear to me, even though little tidbits and rumors had been drifting down the line about what this movie was going to be like. But it was when I had a script in my hands for the first time, and I think Charles appears on page 7 or 8 the first time, and I read the description of the setting where he physically was, that I realized indeed all the rumors were true. This was not going to be a conventional X-Men movie.
There's a lovely scene at a dinner table in the film. Wonderfully nostalgic, both for the audience and hopefully for yourselves as well as the actors. But I was wondering, over the past 17 years, is there a particular moment you look back with a certain fondness as your time of being Charles Xavier, like a particular moment or a line, or maybe both on screen or off screen?
Well, yes, there was, and it's in this movie, and it's in that scene, in fact. It's only a few seconds and only a couple of lines, but James Mangold is a director who comes with a very strong vision, a clear vision, and a strong way of communicating it, of what he believes is needed. But, and it's a huge and fabulous but, he is also, once the actors begin to work, he loves taking what the actors are doing and then playing with it, playing around, rather than just sticking to his personal vision. The actor's vision becomes part of the whole. And there was a moment in that scene when we're talking, there's a boy in the scene, the family's young man, and he's talking about dropping out of school. And Logan says, well, you know, you be careful what you're saying, because this man, he used to be headmaster of a school, he ran a school. And I think round about then we cut the scene and James said, why don't you just improvise that conversation? Just, you know, play with it, see what happens. You know, tell them about what it was you did. So we had, I would say, a 7 or 8 minute improvisation on camera, of which only a couple of lines have made it into the movie. But there they are. And Hugh fed me, and what I had to do was to try to tell this family we had just met what kind of school it was that I had run without actually saying that actually it was a school for mutants and superheroes.
Don't give it away.
Yeah, and that was so much fun on camera to be able to. And maybe it'll make it, you know, into the, you know, the
extras and the DVD,
extra stuff. I enjoyed that very much.
And there's a sadness in your character in the film, but there's also the opportunity to be quite funny as well in a number of moments. And I want to say, I think you're personally responsible for one of the funniest videos that exists on the internet, which is a bold statement, but it's the outtakes of your extras conversation with Ricky Gervais. And of course, you're reunited with Stephen Merchant in the film.
Yes.
And I was wondering, did you, please tell me, you recreated some of your extras moments with Stephen in the film?
Well, we have in the past, when we've met, talked about extras. And, you know, because Stephen was very responsible for a lot of the script of extras, along with Ricky. And that was a very important afternoon in my life, because that's all it was. That scene in the trailer was half an afternoon's work, and it changed everything for me, because all of a sudden people were saying, "Was this Patrick Stewart is funny? How come? Well, let's give him another shot." And so Seth MacFarlane cast me in American Dad, and then in Family Guy, and I did his voiceovers for Ted. Ted too. I go on Colbert and do sketches, and it is almost like a new career that I've discovered very, very late in my career.
Well, it's a very enjoyable career. Patrick Stewart, it's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Good to see you.
And you could have it all. still have time.